TLO, what's poppin'? We are on Twitch. We are not live, but you can leave a like, comment, subscribe, turn on your post notification bells. Let's continue to grow the family from Chicago to the UK. You know what I'm saying? Guess who hit me up today? The Sidemen. Woo! If you happen to miss a live, this is where it will be. Don't forget, we do got the Discord as well, and we got the Patreon. The link to that is all in the description, man. It's in the link tree in the description. Let's get into this, man. Where is it? Most painful things in the world. Okay. Okay, okay. I had to look up their names. Okay, we got Vic. KSI, I know who KSI is. I had to look up Vic's name. I didn't know who Vic was, man. My bad, Vic. And then we got Toby. I know who Toby is. I just learned yesterday. I've seen videos. I'm terrible at names, so.
A punch from KSI did not make this video's list of the most painful things you can experience in the world.
How?
I don't know, man.
How, Sway? How's that impossible? I am the most powerful being of all beings.
Shush. Sharp and watch the video. Let's go.
Everyone remembers painful experiences.
Oh, wait, whoa, like whoa, that time whoa, 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 whoa. Alright. That's fine. Can't be bitter. You know what I'm saying? That's, you want that spot? Take it. I'm going to go ahead and get up here. I'm chilling up here anyway. No biggie to me. Now my body all in the screen. You know what I'm saying? All right. That's cool.
Paper blew off the table in class and gave you the world's worst paper cut on your scrotum. Or what? Even worse.
Hello? I don't recall that one happening.
Wait, first of all, why are you naked, bro? Why are you naked in class?
Yeah, no, first of all, whoa. No piece of paper has ever got that close to my sack.
When you had to go to the hospital to have the surgeons operate on the sole of your foot to remove that one-by-one Lego brick. If you thought they were bad experiences, then buckle up to hear painful experiences that are even worse.
Well, Toby, you're clearly a menace.
Worse than that torture, here are the most painful things people ever experienced.
I don't know if I'm going to enjoy this, to be honest.
Childbirth. The wonderful miracle of life.
Let's stop right here. I've witnessed childbirth, and it was painful to witness. My baby mama actually took it like a G. I don't know how she ain't. She ain't screaming nothing. She was making noise. No, she screamed like slightly, but like I would have been nervous. I don't know. She
Most women go through it. 9 months of gestation. Then out of it comes a baby.
Nah, let's be real though. Gang kicked in the balls.
Alright, shut up. Nah, press play, Vic, press play.
Even the smallest one is still pretty big.
Did he just try to compare getting kicked in the balls to pregnancy? I don't think that's a valid.
Now imagine it coming out.
What?
Of you. Some women described it feeling like they were having their organs ripped out. But that's not all the pain a woman goes through.
I guarantee you, JJ, I guarantee you couldn't even handle a period, let alone actual
childbirth.
It's just
like a big poo.
Maybe your childbirth was a big poo.
Oh, can we just watch the video?
Some women paint a very painful picture of it. They say it's like your body being punched.
Bro said it's like a big poo. No, bro. You're a hole that's normally this big opens up to 10 centimeters, then fits a head, shoulders, stomach out.
Twisted.
Bro,
and out from
I literally take that daily. I always get punched.
They say it's like your body being punched, twisted, and wrung out from the inside.
You ain't been punched from the inside.
How badly are you getting worked in your sparring, bro, if you're getting ringed out from the inside? I don't want to hear it.
That's not sparring anymore, Vic.
I thought your defense was so good, JJ. What, you're telling me that when you train every day it's as bad as childbirth?
No,
I don't
want to
hear it.
Yeah, they're getting in it.
Okay. Let's just listen.
Some women can spend a lot of time going into labor before they actually.
Where do they do this at? Hey, what y'all do? Like, y'all just call each other over, like, FaceTime or something? Not FaceTime, but, like, one of these apps where y'all can all work together? This is nice.
We deliver the baby. The longest labor ever recorded was for 75 days.
Bro, at 75 days, give me a C-section. 75 days? You telling me my birth day was supposed to be 75 days ago?
Like, 75 days? Down. Bro, no. I could do that in, like, 30 seconds.
You need to
Look, you lying so hard, you slobbering. Why are you trying to think that you could do pregnancy? What's going on? Do you identify as something else? Like, what, like, I'm lost. No, no funny stuff. I'm just curious.
It's a 12 and a half minute video, and you paused it 5 times in the
first
minute.
Just to chat utter shit. I feel sorry for the viewers at home. They just want to find out what's painful. Do you know what, actually? The most painful things we can experience is fucking you.
Being in a reactive JJ.
All in all, it's a wonder why women keep putting themselves through it. Number 9, tetanus. All
right.
Tetanus is a very well-known bacterial disease. It's an infection that affects your nervous system. It's famous for causing muscle spasms. It is also
I feel like
known
I'm more
as
scared of tetanus than I should
because
be.
Because the spasms tend to begin in the jaw. Even worse, the jaw lock can also make breathing harder. Overall.
So y'all think, I'm not even gonna lie, like, I know this is a serious thing, but like tetanus, like, y'all think a lot of nitties and C-R-A-C-K heads, and you know, people off them class A's be going through this same thing every day. My bad.
Well, it's a
I
very
swear
tough
I've had
disease.
That before when licking out pussy.
Okay.
You good, bro?
Hey.
Bro, my jaw locks. You know what
you
I mean? That one's, we've all been there, yeah?
No. No, I'm not eating. I'm not doing that for that long. I'm finna penetrate. You know what I'm saying?
Well, eat out.
Oh, I'm so tired of this video, and it's been not even 2 minutes into the video. Just shut up.
Something wrong.
The spasms can last up to a few minutes. They usually occur for a period of 4 weeks and frequently. Some people who had tetanus described it as a living hell. The spasms can be so violent that it's not rare for them to cause bone fracture.
I kind of missed Zerka and what's the bloody name? Harry. Where's Harry and Zerka?
Tetanus is commonly caused by a puncture. Things like rusty nails or rusty fences can easily carry the tetanus.
So basically, he been eating girls out on their time of the month. Because it tastes rusty, like pennies. Bloody. Crazy. I'll clarify that.
And there isn't a known cure for the disease. Thankfully, a vaccine was
just
invented
make
that can help
orgasm,
prevent
brother.
Tetanus. So make sure you're vaccinated. Get your boosters when you need them.
Let's have a talk real quick. Nothing's this funny. The video honestly is not this funny. You know what I'm saying? Hey, Vic! I'm on your side, bro. It's only been 2 minutes. Like, y'all video is 15 minutes. Now my video is gonna be 20. Like, this is crazy. Chill, okay? Give us a moment.
Number 8, cluster headaches. Everyone's had a headache.
I don't know about
also
this
have
one.
Migraines.
What is this?
Tough. A few unlucky people.
Hey, I'm going to sit next to JJ and make sure he cool, bro. I'm going to sit right here, man. Let me, okay, all right.
Cluster
number 8, it's worse than
they
tetanus.
Feel so much pain, bro. They can't even think straight. This is a neurological disorder. Cluster headaches are much worse than even the worst headaches, and they usually occur around the eye. The headaches are excruciating and recurrent. Some describe it as similar to feeling a hot rod going into your eye. Others say it feels like their temple and eye are being cut open while they're being electrocuted and burnt. The symptoms can last for minutes to even 3 hours.
Never had that. You think chiropractor will help align your spine and things of that nature, lower bottom, the lower half of your neck?
The worst, though, is that these headaches come in clusters, so they tend to go away for a period of time and come back just as viciously in painful batches. Some clusters can even last up to a year. No one knows the true cause of this kind of headache.
I'm feeling slightly better about my existence right now.
God forbid.
Touch wood.
I literally eat that for breakfast.
Okay.
No, honestly, I've had headaches that have been like
Is giving me a cluster headache. Shut up.
The condition is more...
With the state of JJ head, no offense, I'm just, you know, saying, I believe that you've had some crazy headaches. Like, I'm next to you, but like, if you take that bandana off, like, we all know. Like, if I take my hat off, I ain't got no lying either. You know, it gets critical, but I know you have some crazy headaches, bro.
More common in men than women. They can occur at any age, but usually they start around the age of 20. These headaches are also known as suicide headaches. Because the pain can be so much that it triggers people to consider unthinkable thoughts.
Number seven,
trigeminal neuralgia.
Who?
Trigeminal neuralgia is a condition that affects the
trigeminal
nerve. Don't know it, neither did I. But apparently this nerve has a very crucial job, which is to carry sensations from your face to your brain. So, if you have trigeminal neuralgia, any stimulation of your face can cause excruciating pain. Things like brushing your teeth, putting on makeup, or even smiling results in a pain a million times worse than something like biting your tongue.
Oh my God, my daughter bit her tongue for the first time last week. Keep in mind, she ain't know what was happening. She was so shocked. I had to see if she was okay. And then I went in the room and I died of laughter. I didn't want to laugh at her face, but this was funny.
Described it as having a monster on their face. Others say that anytime something touches your face, you feel like you got shot.
A monster on her face. That's what she said. All right,
shot.
Some people just
this condition happens when the nerve is disrupted, usually caused by a blood vessel. This pain disorder happens more commonly to women than men. It also usually occurs in people older than 50. There isn't a cure for the disorder yet, unfortunately. But doctors can usually try to control and manage it through medication and sometimes surgery. Number 6, stonefish. The stonefish is a sneaky little critter. They're experts at camouflage, hiding amongst stones and other things alike, which is a bad thing for humans. That's because they're the most venomous fish in the world. Wow. All stonefish have very...
Damn. See, that's why I stay away from the ocean anyway. You get me, JJ and Toby? Toby? JJ? I don't be in the ocean. We don't do that. I don't know about you, Vic. You might could swim great. But for sure, I don't... Maybe KSI, because you got money now. You done took swimming lessons. Toby? Normally, I don't do it. I'm not getting in nobody's ocean. I'm good.
Very sharp, needle-like spine.
Why do we go in the sea, man?
If you ever step on...
Oh, so Vic, you feel...
Bro, I've been saying this, Vic.
All the worst stuff is in the sea.
Honestly, the only reason I go into the sea is to knock out sharks.
If you ever step on... It's bad news to you. That's because
the video is playing
very strong poison. This poison causes severe pain on your feet and legs. It will even cause you to swell up a lot. That's not all. It can also cause headaches, rashes, heavy cramps, and even death. One unlucky person who got stung painted a horrible picture about his experience. He described the pain as holding an oxy welding torch on your foot. Then it works its way up your whole leg for an hour. After that, it feels like smashing your...
Australia! Y'all see this? I'm telling you. Listen. I told y'all last video, Australia got too much. Man, it's too much going on in Australia for me.
...leg with a sledgehammer every 10 seconds. Ouch. After hearing that...
I don't care that it was in Fiji. It happened to an Australian man.
If this happens to me, I'm just saying, like, put me to sleep. I need to ride this one out, bro. Just knock me out with whatever you got, bro. I don't.
Okay, JJ, here's your time. Say knock him out with a punch or something.
I'm gone. I'll see you on the other side.
Wait, can I?
JJ's there, like, let me punch. Yeah, there he is.
Yeah.
And we know you.
I feel like one of the guys, honestly.
I'm sure there's more efficient ways.
Ego isn't so bad.
I don't know if that was a
Thankfully, the anti-venom is widely available. But if you ever feel a sting on your foot when you dive, you need to rush straight away to the hospital. That will save you.
I don't think acupuncture
experience.
Is going to help, to be honest.
Yeah. Number 5, second degree burn. You might be thinking, well, what about third degree burns? Many people don't know it.
Third degree, you can't feel. You can't feel. All the nerve endings are gone. Second degree, before you say anything, I've had second degree burns, and I don't have any finger. I don't have any feelings in my fingers no more. Well, it's coming back now, like years later, but I've had second degree burns, and it hurt terribly.
Yeah, bro, I get this all the time, especially when I'm in the studio.
No, you don't. Because none of that shit's fire. My bad.
Degree of pain isn't related to the degree of the burn. Second degree burns are actually the most painful type. That's because a third degree burn goes through all your tissue and destroys your nerve endings. So in that way, the burnt area feels numb, which is not the case with second degree burns.
Shut up! It wasn't funny! The silence was funny! The joke was shit! Okay?
With second degree burns, there's pain, redness, swelling, and blistering. They affect the epidermis and the dermis, but not the nerves. The result is a very painful.
Hey, I'm gonna go sit by Toby for the. I'm gonna go sit by Vic for the rest of the video, bro. You over here giggling in my ear. I can't. I'm trying to pay attention. What's good, bro? My bad. Let me back up a little bit. Ah, here we go.
Painful experience indeed. Ever burned yourself while cooking? Now imagine sustaining
Shut
a
up,
way
JJ.
More serious and prolonged burn. Some people
are sorry. Who let him cook?
Damn, I gotta sit over here because they keep doing this.
Cook!
Said that the aftermath is equally as painful. For example, during treatment while tending the burned area. With this type of burn, it usually takes 2 or 3 weeks for the area to heal. Thankfully, there is medicine that helps with infections, the pain, and it'll help heal the burn. Sometimes, surgery is necessary to remove the damaged tissue and replace it.
That's grim. Like, your tissue must actually die and, like, shit fucking starts growing in it. That's wild.
Number 4. Durkheim's disease.
What the fuck is that?
Durkheim's disease is an extremely rare disease.
Oh, I've seen this.
It causes big, fatty tumors to grow beneath a person's skin.
Oh, wow. Is this like what the people with elephantitis get? Like, or no, that's something else. But the elephant man would call this or something?
They tend to grow around the extremities of the body and on the torso. Multiple lumps appear on the person. Worse yet, these lumps can cause a whole deal of pain.
Oh, there's a girl, there's a lady on TikTok who got this, but it's in her butt. So it looked like she's just thick.
They do that because they press on nearby nerves, activating pain receptors. Some people with extreme
But it doesn't hurt, so it's not the same. Alright, my bad, y'all.
Cases describe it as feeling like all the fat in your body is hurting. Sometimes, people with Durkheim's disease feel pain, even if they sit completely still, doing nothing. Durkheim's disease was first found by Francis Xavier Durkheim in 1892. But even though it's been known for so long,
yourself? I honestly don't know.
That's how it used to be, though. You used to name whatever you found out. If you were the first to find it, you name it after yourself.
I guess so. Well, I don't know. Just to be popular, innit?
Notoriety.
Clout.
No one knows what's the cause of Durkheim's disease. Some believe it's hereditary.
Why is this stressing me out thinking I could just cop any of these random things for
Others
no reason?
Believe it's
I don't
an autoimmune disorder.
I rebuke them.
I was better off not knowing, isn't it?
Durkheim's disease has a bigger chance of happening to women, especially middle-aged or have gone through menopause. It often shows up between the age of 45 to 60 years. Number 3, bullet ant sting. The bullet ant is a species of ant known for its very powerful sting.
I bet you they're in Australia somewhere.
The ant is native to rainforests in Central and South America. This ant can grow up to 1.2 inches long and are sort of similar to wasps, minus the wings. Just the sight of one of them can be pretty intimidating. The bullet ant's sting is ranked as the most painful sting, according to the Schmidt Sting Pain Index. which is a scale that compares the sting of a bunch of different species, like wasps, bees, and ants.
They got put on the eye.
I know, right? Who on earth put their name forward to test that? And just in case you're wondering, yes, the bullet ant gets its name because the pain is similar to getting shot.
Okay. Wow.
Just imagine having one of these bite your eye, and you've probably just imagined the worst pain possible. Some describe it as a throbbing ache, with waves of burning sensations, and all-consuming pain that can last for over a whole day.
I find stinging horrible, that right? rough, so I can't even
well,
imagine.
Well, it's part of an initiation rite for a Brazilian tribe called the Sitarimawe. The rite is...
Look, I can't go against tradition. It is what it is, so I ain't even gonna speak on it.
...meant to turn boys into warriors. In it, the Indians grab hundreds of ants and weave them into gloves made of leaves. The boys then have to put their hands on the glove for 5 full minutes. When the rite is over, the boy's hands and arms are paralyzed and will be that way for days.
That's
Not
crazy.
Only that, the boy may shake uncontrollably for days. Sounds like the warriors of that tribe are pretty stupid. Tough. Number two, the tub. The tub was one of the cruelest forms of torture ever created.
What?
It's also known as scaphism, and it was invented by the Persians. This is how it worked.
I used to mess with a Persian girl in high school. Beautiful. She just had a baby. I miss her. Shout out to her husband, though. But just know if she ever came back, y'all getting a divorce.
The victim would be put into two wooden tubs or canoes with their head and legs sticking out. Then, their head and legs would be doused in honey in order to attract bees and other things. Said critters would repeatedly attack the victim as they do. Guess that's where they got the inspiration for that famous Nicolas Cage scene in The Wicker Man. But it doesn't stop there. The torturers actually kept feeding the victim milk and honey in order to keep them alive. That also led them to have horrible bowel movements. They would eventually fill the container with their excrement, allowing insects and maggots to breed and proliferate, eating their flesh. This would happen until the person became deceased. It could be from the stings, the septic shock, or the gangrene.
Yeah, that's a different type of evil right there.
No good options there.
That's one of the most
Coming
horrible
up,
things I've ever heard of.
It's something so painful that it became a popular
expression. How do you even think of that?
You gotta be fucked up in... I reckon Simon could come up with that idea. You gotta be fucked up in the head to come up with that.
Simon definitely caught a stray there.
No, if there's any one of the
Number
Simon
one,
to come up with a
Ling
punishment
Chi.
Like that, I reckon
Have
Simon.
You ever heard the phrase, death by a thousand cuts?
Yes.
That's literally what Ling Chi is. Ling Chi is a form of torture. And eventually, execution, devised by the Chinese. The actual translation is something akin to lingering death or slow slicing. In it, the prisoners would be tied to a wooden frame and displayed in public. The torturer would then use a knife to remove small pieces of flesh over an extended period of time. The torturers would make sure no deadly cuts would be made, so the death would be as prolonged as possible. The Chinese believe this punishment.
What did you do to get that type of sentence, though? Like, what you had to do?
It worked on three different levels. First, it was a slow and painful death. Second, it worked.
Hey, Vic! You cool?
Worked as a form of public humiliation. And lastly, it worked as a punishment.
Toby, you up there on your phone. We see you.
After death. That's because the Chinese believe that by cutting the body of their victims, their soul wouldn't be complete in the afterlife. The Chinese started the practice around the year 900, and it was only banished in 1905. What looked like the most painful thing for you?
I didn't enjoy any of that.
Well, I'm sure someone watching this is gonna type that on Google. Or
I wouldn't recommend it. Yeah. I would say crack on with your day and be grateful that...
Just move on. TLL, leave a like, comment, subscribe, turn on your post notification bells, man. Hey, listen, y'all. Okay, you cool. You and you. Y'all better come with more energy next time. You get Harry and Zerka back here. I'm gone.